about your sex?
Matthew says you're his lawyer. That is correct. It's kind of a loser of a case. What would possess you to take it?
I disagree with your assessment. I don't think it's a loser of a case. I think your son has a legitimate claim.
It would be kind of fun to stick it to me, though, wouldn't it?
That is not why I am taking the case, Nora.
Then why? It's not as if there's any money in it, because Matthew certainly doesn't have any.
My expenses are being paid in full.
By whom?
Matthew and I have an arrangement. And that's all I'll say on the matter. Have you talked to Matthew about this?
Yeah, of course we've talked.
Okay, and have you listened to him? I mean, really listened to him? He feels powerless, Nora. He sees hope for the first time in his life since the accident, and you won't let him anywhere near it. This surgery could allow him to walk again.
Or kill him. It could kill him, Taya. Have you looked at the numbers, Delgado? Because Beau and I have. And yeah, there's a lot of swagger and promise on the Evan side of this equation, but then there are the cold, hard numbers.
Greg Evans has a great record with this surgery.
I came within a breath of losing my son by accident. I'm not going to deliberately put his life at risk.
That's about you, Nora. That's not about Matthew.
My son is standing on the edge of a cliff ready to jump, and you are cheering him on. Please, God, don't do this, Taya. Please, I'm begging you, don't do this. My son is 15 years old. He's still a child.
And he wants a chance at a real life.
He's got one now! And when he grows up, he'll understand that.
That's easy for you to say.
Listen, every kid wants something in life that isn't right or isn't safe. That's why parents have to be the one to say no, because kids don't have the maturity to make a judgment that could affect their whole life or end it.
You trot out your medical experts. I'll put Dr. Evans on the stand, and we'll let the court decide if this is one of those times.
You know, if you had kids, you'd feel differently. I'm pretty damn sure about that.
Maybe you're right. But I have made a commitment to Matthew, and I'm not going to back down.
No matter what I say.
Why don't you try saying it to Matthew and really listen to him this
time? You don't think I've been listening?
Apparently not, or we wouldn't be here right now. There is still time to keep this out of court.
Yeah, why don't you tell him how bad the odds are for him in court?
That's not what I meant. I meant you two could settle this by yourselves. And for the sake of your relationship, I sure hope you do. But in the meantime, I will be taking my cues from my client.
You know, Tay, someday you are going to have a kid of your own. And then you're going to understand what you've done.
Then you can say I told you
so. No, I won't. I'll just say it. Just feel sorry for you.
It's all yours.